Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you subtractor in computer. And to understand subtractor, there are few very interesting concepts that I need to explain. So I can give you guarantee once you see this video, you will be able to understand many interesting concepts which are there regarding computer. So let me explain you first how subtraction is happening in layman's language. Then I'll explain you how exactly we perform subtraction inside computer, and then we will form circuit based on subtraction operation, right? So when we talk about subtraction operation in layman's language, then you should know, as if you write z is equals to x minus y, then simply I can say we have performed subtraction of x minus y, that is z over here, right? Now as if you want to understand that in computer's language, then first of all you need to know, like, there is no such thing like minus which is happening inside computer, right? So how do we perform subtraction? So that is what we are performing by simply addition only. Now question is how? See, here you perform what? X minus y. But as if I say you perform x plus negative of y, then you can say you are performing x minus y, right? So how minus y is there in computer? Minus of y, that is 2's complement of y, that you can say. So in computer, negative data representation that we do using 2's complement, right? So x minus y that we perform as per x plus 2's complement of y, right? Now how to have 2's complement? So 2's complement means 1's complement plus 1. Remember this. 2's complement means 1's complement plus 1. Now what is 1's complement? 1's complement is inversion of that data. 1's complement of x, that is x bar. 1's complement of y, that is y bar. Plus 1, that is 2's complement. So here, this 2's complement of y, that is 1's complement of y, that is y bar, plus 1. Now here, my dear students, I have seen students are thinking like something plus 1 is equals to 1. But remember, this is modulo 2 addition, right? This is modulo 2 addition. This is not Boolean function. So here this z is equals to x plus y bar plus 1. This is not Boolean function. I have seen students are saying like, sir, as if you write x plus 1, then that is always 1 as per Boolean function, right? But this is not Boolean function. This is expression which I have written in form of modulo 2 addition, right? So this is not Boolean function. First of all, remember this. Now, if you see this modulo 2 addition, in that, how many bits that we are adding? You see, we are adding 3 different bits. One is x, second is y bar, and third is 1, right? That is how we are performing 3 different bits of addition, where one is 1. Second is x and third is y bar. Now here, what I'll do is, first I'll explain you one basic property of XOR gate, and by using that property of XOR gate, I'll explain you how we can have subtraction operation, right? So you must know how exactly truth table is there with XOR gate. So as if I say I'm having 2 input XOR gate, right? So in that, here you see inputs are 00, 01, 10 and 11, right? So what is my output over here with XOR gate? That output should be 0 1 1 0 with XOR gate, right? Now my dear students, how we will be using this property, just see this carefully. As if I say I'm having one selection line S, and here my one input is Y, then what will happen over here? You see, when this S is 0 0, you see, at that time, y is 0, 1 over here. And you see, my output of XOR gate, that is y only. But when this s, that is 1, means one input is 1, at that time, when input is 0, 1, output is 1, 0, what it means? My output is y bar over here. So here, what is the property which is there with XOR gate? XOR gate explains with two terminal XOR gate, as if one input is 0, then output will be my second input. But as if one input is 1, then output will be inversion of second input, right? So when S is 0, output is Y over here, and when S is 1, at the time output, that is Y bar. Now I'll be using this property to form adder subtractor circuit, right? So let us consider this is my full adder circuit, right? Let us consider this is my full adder circuit. Now with full adder circuit, how many inputs are there? Three lines of inputs are there, right? One input that will be X only, that is this. My second input that I cannot give as Y over here, right? With full adder, what is my output? Output will be X plus Y. So here I'm not going to give Y as output. What I'll be doing is here I'll be connecting one XOR gate over here, and one input will be Y over here, and second input that I'll be considering as selection line. Now I'll explain you how exactly this selection line is helping you to have that subtraction, but consider second line of this XOR gate, that is selection line, right? And with full adder, third input will be C in, right? For one input is X, second input is output of this XOR gate, where XOR gate is having input Y and selection line, and third input, that is selection line, right? And my output, that is, let us say Z over here, and I can say C out means carry out, right? That is how my outputs are there with this full adder circuit. Now I'll explain you, this circuit is functioning as full adder as well as full subtractor. Let me explain you how exactly this is functioning over here. So my dear students, if you see the situation with S is equals to 0. So when S is equals to 0, what will happen? You see, when S is 0, at that time XOR gate output is Y, means when S is equals to 0, at that time here you will be having Y, right? So this 0 that will come here, right? So what is this Z? This Z that will be X plus Y plus 0, means it will be X plus Y, right? So you can say this circuit is functioning similar to full adder circuit. Okay, this is functioning to full adder circuit. Now let us consider second situation. So in second situation, as if you have S is equals to 1, as if you have S is equals to 1, what will happen? You see, so now let me take another color so it will gives you a bit more clarity. When S is equals to 1, what will happen with XOR gate? You see, when S is equals to 1, at that time my output will be inversion of second input. So here when S is equals to 1, at that time this XOR gate output, that will be Y bar, right? So in that situation, you see this 1 that will come here. So what is this Z? Z will be X plus, now this will be Y bar plus this will be 1, right? And if you see, I have already told you how computer can perform that subtraction. X plus 2's complement means X plus Y bar plus 1, right? So this is what subtraction, right? So when selection is 1, at that time this full adder circuit with the usage of this XOR property, there will be subtraction, right? So subtractor, that is functioning as I have explained it over here, right? So with the usage of property of XOR gate, we can make full adder circuit as a subtractor. And here I have made this circuit in this way. The reason is, I have seen many of the times inside computer we need to perform addition as well as subtraction. So if you have one full adder, why you should be making another circuit for subtractor? Only thing that you can do over here is you can provide this XOR gate and provide one selection line. Once you provide it in this way, what will happen? Entire circuit which is there for subtractor, that could be used as adder, right? So that's why I have made this circuit in this way. I hope it is clear to you. Still, if anything that you like to share it with me, please note it down in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.